Wish them all the best, of course, if they can actually do what they did in 1977.
This is 2016. That in Lagos, Nigeria defeated Egypt 4-0.
Wow.
They can do that in Kaduna. They can, right?
Just try to imagine the Super Eagles beating this current Egyptian team 4-0.
That would be massive. That would be massive.
Now, you see,
what are you going to do if it happens?
Oh, I'm in Nigeria now. Feel good.
No, not feeling good. Something extra. You need to, because it's like, you're not sure that's going to happen.
I'll smash some more of the show. Cecilia, what?
Something.
But that's a good thing to ponder on, because yeah. I was at the Ahmadou Bello Stadium when we defeated Chad.
Yes, of course.
And controlling the crowd was a problem. Chad with 2-0. So now this is a scoop to the NFF to ensure that we have good crowd control measures. We beat Egypt 4-0.
They blew the roof. Just can't wait.
Nigeria Football Federation, I think. That's a lot of work. You should start getting it now to ensure that there are good crowd control measures, enough stewards, security personnel on ground, because it will be a good way. You see,
because they want to hug the players. It's not if they're trying to do anything bad.
The players run out of the pitch against Chad.
They'll need to actually, just shake the players or just want to get close. Excitement and all the joy. Yeah.
Can't explain it. It's just be overflowing. That would be fantastic for Nigerian football, 1977, 2016. Wow, a lot has happened.
A lot has happened, yeah. Since that, I've not really beaten Egypt as much as this. If it can happen, then it will definitely be one of the biggest pull-off this season for the Super Eagles, because they've been really, really bad. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the Flamingos. We were supposed to have talked to the coach this morning, but then they're in training right now. The South Africans are already in town. They are in town. They will be facing the under-17 team Flamingos of Nigeria this Saturday on the 12th. And, of course, that game is definitely going to be 4 p.m. in Abuja at the Abuja National Stadium. Of course, the gate will be thrown open. It's free if you're in Abuja. Right. Please just go there and cheer the girls to victory. If not for anything, at least for Rashidat Ajibade. She's really been wonderful in that team. Of course, they'll be playing some friendlies here and there.
To use it to wrap up International Women's Day celebration.
Just go and celebrate with the ladies. Yeah. Celebrate with the girls. Mm. They will definitely appreciate that. That will be something that will be wonderful. So after that, the return leg will be in SA, and of course, if they just finish it like what they did with the Namibians, right? 9 goals aggregate, that would be wonderful. They've never failed to qualify for the FIFA under-17 Women's World Cup, so it's always wonderful. So we're expecting another one. They'll definitely be in another final.
With the Flamingos, the Falcons, I don't know about the Super Falcons for now. No shaking. And I tell you why. Because at that level, the girls understand the need to consolidate, to keep getting better. That's why a lot of women's football followers are like you and I, when we see the same names over and over again,
like
we start asking questions.
Because
we have the quality. Even look at the league, we have the qualities. And in Africa, at the under-17 and under-20 stage, who can come close? We defeated Namibia 4-0 in Abuja, went to Windhoek and then defeated 5-0, 9-0 aggregates. South Africa, they're doing so much for their women's football now. You can see
they're doing like 90% of what we are not doing. We're doing 10%, they're doing 90%, and we're still better. So the talent is definitely here,
and that's why we're worried that we're playing South Africa. 4 years ago, you played South Africa, you worried. 5 years ago, because we know that we don't have the right machinery in place to even empower our players. That's why we have this against our other. But I'm confident that the Flamingos, we beat them in Abuja, but maybe in SA. Those are the Bantwana girls who just come out and maybe score. But I still think we have the quality to beat them. Yeah. Let's just fix administration.
Yeah, that's it. Sometimes
you don't even know who to talk to. As you guys, women's football in Nigeria, to even promote it.
Okay, what's the update right now? The chairperson of the league, Delichiku, she's no longer there. The board was dissolved. Constituted. You have a Baba Ganam, something that is in charge of the committee, supposed to set up how they're going to have elections and all that. The league hasn't started because those guys were giving 1 month, to put it in order. So because of that, we're not hearing anything from anybody. And you mentioned Super Falcons. Super Falcons, you have about 26 players right now in camp.
Out of the 40
that was invited and all that, most of the foreign-based players are not there, except I think the captain, Evelyn Wambuku, she is in camp right now. And Chijina is actually trying to put the girls together and really talk to them, see how they can, you know, move it forward. So all the home-based players are there because the league hasn't started, so they don't have a choice than just to be there and just be training before, you know, the foreign-based players will join them and before they will play their first game. That's updates coming from the Super Focus. Mm. Hopefully the league can start soon because we're not hearing anything from anybody, and if they can start the league very soon, that will be a big plus for the women's league in Nigeria. Okay.
Ronaldo Delima didn't get to win the UEFA Champions League. He's a fantastic player, but record has it that he didn't win the UEFA Champions League.
Sometimes just be at the right club at the right time. If he had stayed at Barcelona,
yeah,
of course, he would have counted too right now. So that's why sometimes when you're in a particular club, they've got the potential, just stay there.
What is it saying?
Well, PSG winning Champions League, well, it can happen.
If I win the AUJ Cup, I'm not the I'm not the same journalist, you know.
Really?
What's that saying? If I win the Swan Cup,
it's not going to change anything.
If I win the Swan Cup with the Channels football team, well,
he has won so many trophies.
We'll become champions.
So
I
he feels with different clubs, he feels Champions League will just be an addition.
But what Zlatan is forgetting is time is taken away.
Yep.
And yeah, very soon it's only over for him. So imagine winning the Champions League at this stage is really admirable. Okay, that's
definitely
it.
We'll look at just League results before we go straight to the papers.
That's right.
Yeah, what happened last night, man. We knew, you know, Cristiano Ronaldo was definitely going to score.
That's
but
right.
We didn't know how many goals he was going to score. But actually scored one. James Rodriguez is good. He's scoring once again. He also was on score sheet because Real Madrid beating AS Roma 2-0 and 4-0 on aggregate. And you, Zinedine Zidane, was saying, look, it was a difficult game, as in it was happy that they were able to cross through a difficult hurdle. And I'm looking at what I have on the screen. I'm looking at 4-0 on aggregate. Okay, that must be pretty really difficult. For Wolfsburg, they had to finish what they started in Belgium the last time, 4-2 on aggregate. 1-0, they won. Draxler, of course, gave them that lone goal victory, and that was enough to see them into the last eight. So we have two teams already. Will Chelsea join them, or PSG, or Zenit St. Petersburg? Which of the teams is going to join them? We're looking at the games for today. And, of course, Chelsea will be up against PSG.
Mm.
That is a big one.
That's right. Crack out of a game right there. Chelsea taking on Paris Saint-Germain, and then Chelsea are still unbeaten in the league. And at Stamford Bridge, they're trying to gain back their superiority under Gus Hiddink. And the players are turbocharged for this one. Listen to Zlatan Ibrahimovic, you know that PSG, they are coming with a tactics. They're trying to keep it low, you know, play like there is nothing in it for them, make Chelsea favorites, but of course, catch them on the counter when they go to sleep, and then PSG gets the job done. It's the UEFA Champions League, anything can happen, but we've seen now that teams that travel decently either get a point or don't concede much.
Okay.
We see the need to consolidate at home.
Mm-hmm.
So it's in recent times, I've known how this team went away, won, and then came back and then they blew it away. So Chelsea with 2-1, win 1-0.
Yeah, definitely. I think they just got two goals and don't concede, then you're good to go.
That's right. So
that's what they can do. They can just keep the defense very, very tight, which most times they can. And under Gus Hiddink, if you check, that's back four. They've actually respected themselves. Costa is back to training. Same thing with Pedro. So definitely, they might just have all their squad, all of them fit for that game. And for Gus Hiddink, well, this might just be another chance to win the Champions League with Chelsea. Remember the last time he came, he won the FA Cup with them. But this would be an opportunity. If he can win the Champions League with them, well, who knows? Chelsea would definitely be a better team. And they won't regret actually letting the special and the former happy one leave the Stamford Bridge, right?
Okay. So let's just take some tweets. We're getting mixed reactions as regards the Maria Sharapova issue. Let's just say it to our viewers. Victor Aquiri on Twitter says, really sad for Maria, one of my favorites. Yeah, I know. Good that she owned up. Lessons she has to keep for memory checks. She also needs to get up. Thank you so much, Victor. And let's create a balance to that one. Henry Omaduvia says, Maria Sharapova was aware of what she was doing. Meldonium is a drug that enhances performance for cardiac patients. He went on to say, Meldonium is not soluble aspirin that you take forever. She was systematically doping. You know that? She should stop this hypocrisy. So, really harsh.
I need to check the profile of that guy.
Yeah, from Henry. But he's entitled to his opinion. Akule Ladipo, showing some love to table tennis in Nigeria, says, I'm so impressed with our table tennis players' constant push on the ranking. Private sector. Private sector support is urgently required. That's mm-hmm. it. That's it. Support. Support. Somebody is doing well. Come on, give him some support.
Is that easy? Better. Is that easy? Because if you listen to Sanin Danusa, he says, just be your best. Put yourself in a particular position and people run after you. If it's football, it's so easy. Or any other sport, it's difficult. But another athlete that have actually break that was able to break even is a Blessing Okagbare when it comes to sports.
That's right.
Of course, Manchester
right.
and others. So right. she is a brand. Overall, because she was able to put herself in that position, of course, mm-hmm. she's getting so much branding. And if Anurang Quadri, who knows, he can even get one or two, and that will also help him. I mean, not spending
other brands, foreign brands are sponsoring. Still, let's mm-hmm. take this
We're
one from
Nigerian brands.
Prince Obioha. He says a medicine that Mariah has been taking for 10 years and only banned 2 months ago. That's harsh because she's innocent. How do you know?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Mixed reactions from the viewers, but it's okay. Presumably, I guess, kudos to those guys, but a rich nation like Nigeria deserves something much better. We should do better. I think it's talking about table tennis in Nigeria. We keep saying it. It will get better.
It will definitely get better. And I love the fact that the ranking right now is showing everyone, look, just put in some money into this. Forget your millions of people. Okay, Sports Day, right. I'm starting with the paper today, with Sports Day. And this one, Iwobi's assist sink Hull City. Okay, but he didn't score. He got an assist there. I don't like the headline I'm seeing. That's why I'm trying to skip it and look around the others. But I just can't escape it because it's right there. Emmanuel Amuneke's Olympic gold medal stolen. Okay, please, if you know where it is, return it to him, because this is really worrisome. Musa wins Best Player Award. Of course, he deserves it. Ighalo vows to score again. He needs it against Arsenal. Of course, Yobo drags Moyes to Port Harcourt for testimony match on May 27.
Okay, we're about to wrap up, but let's just take this one. Front page of the Complete Sports. Ighalo, Eagles can beat Egypt. Oh, home and away. And that's a good one. World first star unfazed by goal drought. And Siasia, we can beat Egypt 4-0 again. We talked about it. Says Nigeria can recreate October 7th feat. So that's it.
Sporting Zone, Now or Never, PSG and Titanic Flash. We'll see what's going to happen in that one. Titanic. Which one is going to sink?
We got to go.
We definitely got to go. Well, I think I love something on Sporting Zone here. Nigeria overtakes Egypt. That's tennis. Keep it up, guys. I mean, not just football and foreign sport dominating your headlines. Tennis, it's there. It shows that they're doing something really wonderful. And, of course, they're bringing it up in the limelight. So that's really important.
Okay, that's Cecilia's
financial. Well, thank you so much for being part of the program. I'm Cecilia Omorogba, and of course, tomorrow we'll be here for another package.
There's still so much to talk about. Remember, you can keep talking to us on Twitter with channels underscore sports, and on Facebook with channels IFA Sports. That's the show. We're getting ready for season 8 of the Channels National Kids Cup. Are you ready? I'm Austin Okonakwa, saying in everything you do, remember to keep talking sports. Bye for now.